Okay, we're going to see into the future, and if you were here, I would have you shuffle this deck of cards as much as you would like. But since you're not here, I get to do your job and my job. So maybe I'll shuffle it one more time. And then what I'll do is I'll just take the cards from you, and I'm going to choose a prediction card. Now, of course, I'm not going to show you ahead of time what the prediction card is. That would not be too much fun, I don't think. I'll put the prediction card over here where you can keep an eye on it. Now, we need a number of cards for this effect, and so, but you're free to choose that number. And so what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to deal out the cards, and I'll state how many, you know, we have at each point in dealing. And then when you feel like we have enough cards, I'll go ahead and stop dealing, okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. You want me to keep going? Okay. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Okay. You want 23 or 24? 23? Okay. That's just fine. We'll go with 23. Okay, so we have this set of 23 cards decided by you, actually. And now what I would like you to do is go ahead and freely cut off any number of cards from here. Okay, I'm going to try to do it and at least leave something. It looks like I just about cut all of the cards. That was genius. But anyway, nonetheless, hopefully we can be successful together. And so you've cut off this number of cards. Now, of course, if you were here, I would have you actually do that cut. So that genuinely is a random cut. It truly, truly is. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to deal out 23 cards a second time. But this time, I want to kind of mix them as we go by deciding kind of when to stop dealing them into piles, and I'll have you decide that. So once again, you'll have to trust that I would perhaps say stop where you would say stop, okay? And if you were here, you genuinely could tell me to stop at any point, as you'll see. Okay, so I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, stop. Okay, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, stop, okay. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, stop. 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, stop. 22, 23. Isn't that how many cards we dealt out, right, the first time? So we have 23 cards, and we're going to stack them in the opposite order to which they were dealt. Okay, and that makes sense here to just really mix these cards. Okay. So I have these 23 cards here, and whose order is actually decided by you, by the way, okay? And if needs be, if you've seen some of my previous performances, I'll use a die roll to decide how many to deal out into each pile, but I wanted to spare you that today. So what we're going to do for the first time, we're going to see how many cards you freely cut. And like I said, I cut a whole bunch of cards. So it's going to make it a bunch of work to count them. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, there's 15 cut cards there. So what we're going to do is deal out the top 15 cards here. And that next card is going to be the card we'll use to determine if indeed we can see into the future. So we said 15, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Oh, 15. We said 15. So 15, okay. So for the first time, let's look at our prediction card. What is our prediction card? It looks like it's the Two of Hearts. Did we indeed see into the future? I believe we did. We found the companion. There's only one companion card. for each card in the deck, and we found it. So in some ways, we've kind of brought some balance to the space-time continuum here. So this is what we saw. That's what I saw. That's why I grabbed the Two of Hearts, because I just felt like, I think we're going to finish with the Two of Diamonds. Okay, so that is the See Into the Future, using a top card and one prediction card. Okay, so let's talk about this and how it works. Now, if you've seen my card effect, the 21 card force on my channel, we're using one of the principles there. Now, you don't necessarily have to understand all of the mathematics of that to make use of this right away. So I don't want to frighten anybody regarding understanding kind of difficult mathematics in order to be able to carry this out. Okay, so how this works is you genuinely can begin with a shuffled deck. You really, really can, okay? So it can be table wash, it can be mixed in any way. And then what you do as the performer, you take the cards from the spectator and you tell them that you're going to be choosing a prediction card, okay? Now the card that you'll be looking for is the companion card to the top card of the deck, okay? So in my mind, I'm just thinking black seven. Find the other black seven, which is the seven of spades. So as I go through here, remember the cards are kind of like this, right? The spectator's not seeing what you're doing. So you go through here and, oh, I spotted it already, okay? And if you want to use a little bit of misdirection and say, oh, okay, this is a good prediction. I'm not feeling good about that one. I don't think that one's very good. I think this is the one I should go with, okay? So you can just kind of pull a funny little thing like that, making it look like you changed your mind. If you recall, the prediction card goes off to the side where the spectator can keep an eye on it. And then if you remember, I had us deal a certain number of cards to the table. Now, it actually doesn't matter how many you deal. Now, you probably should deal 10 or more, otherwise it's not very interesting, especially when we start cutting cards. So some number between, let's say, 10 and 26 is safe, okay? But most spectators will stay in that range just naturally because they get tired of watching you deal them out. So you can count them as you go because you need to know this number. So you can say, okay, I'll deal and I'll count them as we go and then you tell me when to stop. But, you know, maybe allow us to deal out at least 10 of them or something. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Stop. Stop at 17. Okay, 17 is just fine. Okay, and then you pick up the cards. Now, it's at this point we have the spectator cut off a certain number of cards, any number that they like. And it's helpful to maybe turn it sideways just so you can remind yourself that that's the cut pile. Okay, so we have prediction card off to the right, the cut cards at a different angle, and then these are the remaining cards. Now, as they're cutting from this packet, just nonchalantly kind of drop those on top over here, okay, so that we just have three little piles, prediction, and then cut cards, and then the rest of the deck. And then after they've cut those cards, pick this up and explain that you're going to have them deal out that same number of cards, but this time you kind of want to mix them up in terms of order. Okay, so what I did is I did something called the first shall be last, the last shall be first. Now, you would not have to do this dealing out into multiple piles if you'd rather not. What you could do is just deal out another 17 cards. I mean, that would be the most direct way of getting to where we need to be next. But it's nice to give the spectator the feeling that they're making important choices that could affect the outcome, right? They don't want to feel like you're controlling everything, otherwise it's not all that surprising in the end that something, you know, unusual happens. So what I've done is I've used that shuffle. And how this works is, and I'll have to count them as I go because I just want 17. So you deal them out, so 1, 2, 3, 4, until the spectator says stop, and then you go on to the next pile, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Maybe they say stop there, 10, 11, 12, 13. Maybe they say stop there, 14, 15. Maybe they say stop again, 16, 17. Okay, so we have 17 cards dealt out. The exact number in each of these little piles truly is being decided by the spectator. Now the remaining cards we don't need anymore. So you can set them just, you know, off to the side. They're just not needed anymore. Okay. Now if you're going to do what I've done here, instead of just dealing out 17 cards a second time, you need to stack from right to left. And I just simply said, well, we're going to stack them in the opposite order to which they were dealt. That seems like a reasonable thing to do. You know, you just state it without, you know, drawing attention to the fact that maybe they should question that statement. But if you've watched any of my other card performances, you'll realize that this dealing out that we just did with reverse stacking is a packet reversal. It just reverses the cards. Well, that's exactly what happens when you deal cards to the table. 1, 2, 3, you know, you reverse their order. Very good. So we have this new little packet of 17. And I do want to point out a second time, I apologize, that the engine driving this particular version of the routine is the same engine that drives the 21 card effect. And there I go into explaining kind of how that works. But maybe here we're not going to take the time to do that. I use, quote, B brackets, some special mathematical notation to explain why this technique that we're using here actually works every time. Okay, so we've dealt out another 17 cards. And then if you remember, we're almost done actually. We just have to find out, well, how many cards did this spectator freely cut at the beginning? Well, you just count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, 10 cards. And so 10 cards will be the number of cards that you'll remove. Another way of saying this is once you deal out 10 cards, the next card will be the, you know, companion to our prediction card. So you can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And so right here is going to be our special card, the one I noted at the very beginning, okay? And so you can say, you know, at this point, you can say, well, I actually chose a prediction card, you may recall. So let's go ahead and just take a look at what I chose at the very beginning. And is it conceivable that I actually kind of saw into the future and knew where we would arrive after these decisions are being made by you, actually? A lot of random choices are being made by you. So where did it bring us? Oh, I don't know. I think that's very surprising. And the reason I chose that prediction card is in my mind's eye, I could see the Seven of Clubs. So if you follow those steps exactly, it's going to work for you every time. And if you want to look into the mathematics behind this 21 card force technique, go ahead and just take a look at that video. Okay, so that is our first See Into the Future card routine. And I encourage you to watch the other ones that I put together under this heading. So thank you for watching.